adjusting screw and locking it up the top. Or a feeler gauge underneath. Probably going to use a step feeler gauge. They're nice, you can use them. Basic stuff. Torque it afterwards. Once we torque the nut, what are we going to do? Recheck as we call.
Recheck again.
As soon as you put torque on that nut, it changes your clearance, right? Play around, play back and forth, try and get that one to help. Clearance that we need. Okay, low oil pressure. Again, low oil pressure. Going to look for wear in the system. Leakage on the pistons and on those check bolts. If the oil pressure doesn't build up to a high enough value, a slave piston's not going to work. So if we had a system that, a J-brake system that say didn't perform well on all six cylinders, on four cylinders maybe not too bad, but on two cylinders was okay, what would we kind of look towards?
Oil pressure.
Probably oil pressure, yeah. Electrically the system seems to work okay, but the effectiveness gets lower as we try to make more cylinders work. So that would be something like I would look at, possibly a low pressure. You'd also look how many hours are on the engine, how many miles are on the tractor, and kind of go from there. High oil pressure. The higher oil pressure, if it can't be relieved, your exhaust valves are going to stay open. So the engine won't start, it won't fire on those cylinders. Talk about that already. Okay, they talk about operating the J-brake within city limits. And the noise levels have to comply with the EPA, Environmental Protection Agency. So they might ask you a goofy question about that on the Red Seal exam. What level does the noise have to be maintained to? That would be the Environmental Protection Agency limits. I'm not sure what that is in actual sound level, decibels. Truck drivers and guys that ride Harleys like to have loud exhaust systems. Okay, objective 4, explain the function and operations of the exhaust engine, exhaust brake. Okay, the engine exhaust brake is a little bit different than the J-brake system. The exhaust brake is going to work by restricting the flow of exhaust out of your pipe. So that's the way my truck works. Restricts the flow of exhaust, and so you get a brake effect. Exhaust system shutoff valve restricts the airflow through the exhaust system. And this is going to be on your medium duty trucks, right? Your 3/4 ton diesels and higher up to. I think it said 7 and 8. Class 7 and 8 have engine brakes, and below that, up to a 3/4 ton truck would have an exhaust brake. So So the exhaust brake, as I said, it's going to restrict the exhaust system. Here's a picture of a valve that's operated by an air cylinder. And we can do it two ways. We can use a butterfly valve or we can use a sliding pipe valve. Picture on the right shows a sliding pipe valve with an air cylinder to restrict the exhaust system. This is on a turbocharger. Again, we have an air cylinder, and it's going to be closing the butterfly valve in the exhaust system. So, you should know the difference between exhaust brake and engine brake. In engine brake, we're using the valves, exhaust valves. Exhaust brake, we're just restricting the exhaust flow.
Just out of interest, the two classes that they say, obviously, exhaust brake only goes up to about 7, and the engine brakes are generally on if you have. Is that because of the amount of pressure? Because if you did it on a larger engine, it's just tearing off its pieces.
I believe so. The
Class
7 and 8 trucks with 11 liter engines or higher, right?
Yeah.
So they're big, robust engines.
Yes.
And certainly, if you try to do that in my Cummins 6.7 Cummins in my truck, it's not built for that, right? I wish it was, but it's not.
Yeah, I'm kidding.
You know, and it'll just wear that system out in no time. So I truly believe it's because of the robustness of the bigger engines. And we're looking at 15 liter engines in highway tractors now. Not too much on exhaust systems here. I didn't really go here because it's nice to know about the exhaust brakes just because I thought they might be included in off-road haul trucks. We get into scrapers and stuff like that. We're using engine retarders, so no exhaust brakes. They may have an engine brake as well. Okay, I've got highlighted here as the pistons move up in the cylinders on the compression stroke, they work to compress the inlet air as the piston moves up in the cylinders during the exhaust stroke. They work against the air trapped in the exhaust system. So very much like an engine brake, powers absorbed in both cases, piston speed decreases in the crankshaft and therefore the vehicle slows down. So same sort of basic electrical system. We've got a switch to turn it on. We've got a throttle switch. So we have to be off the throttle for it to work. And we're going to use some method to restrict the exhaust. So this one uses an air cylinder. So what can go wrong with this system? Got a cylinder going back and forth, applied by air. It's going to be a seal on that piston. It's going to be a seal on that rod. Hot exhaust system, I would suspect a seal on that rod is probably going to deteriorate. Of course, that's on the atmosphere side of that piston, so it does deteriorate, maybe not the end of the world, but certainly any seal on that piston at that is more effective system. Highlighted area here says other exhaust brakes use the butterfly type of control valve assembly to restrict airflow. So a butterfly valve or a sliding valve for an exhaust brake system. Third one that they don't mention is a variable geometry turbocharger. You close the vanes on the turbocharger, that traps the exhaust system as well. Guys, I didn't mention Mike is going to film, is filming the class here, so you can go back and refer to it later on. So he's going to be coming and going, just so you know what's going on.
Do we get a copy of that?
I think something will give you a link that you can go to and replay it.